Welcome back, I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE. We are here at the awards, and the ceremony's kicked off, and the award winners are here. Tsu-Jae is here, she's the exemplary award. Congratulations, this is a heavy award.
Yes,
this is a big, prestigious award.
Yes, it is.
What's it like up there?
To get that award. It was overwhelming because I didn't realize that the audience would be so large. You know, they represent a global ecosystem, and it was just really heartwarming to see the community come out and support these awards.
You mentioned a story when you were giving your speech about when you were a student.
Yes.
And the time when you were just getting into the industry, and now you're here at the award.
Right.
What's it like to look back and see the innovation today?
Well, there were a lot of innovations that led to where the industry is today, and the impact that semiconductors have had on society. So, you know, I was just one part of a big community.
Yeah.
But looking back, I never would have imagined that the number of transistors on a chip could increase by yet another million times, and you know, the fabs would cost so much, and the equipment. It was just amazing what a community with a shared common purpose can achieve together if we collaborate. And as Dr. Morris Chang indicated, we each specialize in something, but we all collaborate together to achieve something greater than we could each individually. Wonderful things can happen.
And the transistor wave, they're getting there's not much more you can get on these wafers, and it's like, okay, now there's new things happening. The collaboration continues.
Yeah, there's always room for innovation.
What's your feeling now as we look at this demand, the mainstreaming of infrastructure, AI is here, a whole nother set of collaboration is forming.
Yes, yeah. I think the potential impact is, like, I don't think anybody can imagine. Just like we couldn't imagine how the industry has advanced over the past 10, 15 years. But I think we should all be cognizant of the power of technology, that it's a tremendous force for good, but also it could be used for things that are not necessarily the best for humanity. And so this is an important thing for engineering students to learn. How do we ensure they are ethical, but also think about the global impact of their work? How can we ensure that the world is sustainable, inclusive, and peaceful in the future?
Well, congratulations, and thank you so much for stopping by theCUBE here for
our
post-award program.
My pleasure.
Thank you for coming on. I'm John Furrier, theCUBE. Thanks for watching.